Pandemic put a lot of things on hold, including our health. Breast cancer screenings was one of those things. The National Cancer Institute estimates more than 9 million screenings for breast cancer did not happen in 2020. And doctors tell me that they're still working to close that screening gap.
You know, we definitely saw a significant decrease in 2020. We shut down screening mammograms. Women didn't have any other choice. We shut down clinics. We even for a while had to shut down the operating rooms. And so there were women who suffered delays in surgical care as a result of the pandemic in 2020.
Dr. Natasha Reith is a surgical oncologist at Allina Health's Cancer Institute. She's just one of many health professionals working to close the breast cancer screening gap.
Fortunately, what we've seen in the recovery period since is that screening mammograms are now back up to pre-pandemic numbers. So a lot of women are coming back in.
Dr. Reith says that's what they're seeing at Allina Health. But statewide, we're still slowly recovering. Just take a look at the latest data from the Minnesota Department of Health on breast cancer screenings from 2018 to today. You can see the drastic drop that took place at the beginning of the pandemic in 2020 with a slow recovery. But even comparing the numbers from last year to the number of screenings this year, we're still seeing a gap.
For most women, one of the areas we still really struggle with and where I think we need to emphasize and focus is that there are significant disparities in who has come back for mammograms and who got mammograms even pre-pandemic.
Dr. Reith says people in BIPOC communities and transgender individuals are often overlooked when it comes to breast cancer screenings.
There are a lot of either mobile mammography screening events. We partner with local organizations like SAGE to offer free screening events, particularly within some of our communities.
As Dr. Reith mentioned, there's more to the gap than just the pandemic. There's deeper seated issues that need to be addressed. And I get more into that in our digital story, which can be found right now at careliving.com/sunrise. In the meantime, I'm showing you this chart again from the Department of Health SAGE program. You can see steep inclines year after year for the past 5 years during the month of October, which just so happens to be Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So this just goes to show how big of an impact awareness campaigns can make, which is pretty huge. Well, this morning,